Beep. 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 Digimon. 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 Oh! I didn't see you there. Hey, guys. Hello. 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 It is Spitfire again. Why am I whispering? I don't know. Okay. Let's just heal my Pokemon after being, I think it was not gym leader, what do you call them? Gym assistants? Gym, I don't know. Gym assistants. Let's go with gym assistants. Because I can't think of anything else to name them. God damn it. My mind is all blank today. It's just because I've got some holidays. Well, does anyone else call them holidays? Like, yeah. Does anyone else outside the UK call time off school holidays? No, I don't mean like weekends. I mean like, let's see. Just say you have 2 weeks off of school. Do you call that holidays or do you call it a vacation like the Americans? It's like football and soccer, even though England invented football. Most people around the world know it as soccer, which makes no sense because the Americans call football soccer and then they call rugby football, even though you don't use your foot. Yeah. Just think about that. Just think about the guys that call football soccer and rugby football, because it doesn't make much sense. And I'm not putting something against you or anything, but whoever did that must be stupid. Really. The English already have something called football. We should call that soccer. Okay. Take off. That's one thing off. We have football. We call it soccer now. Okay. Next thing. The English have a sport called rugby. What can we call that? Since we got rid of football, let's call that football. Great idea, Mac. Great idea. You okay? Everyone got that on? Yeah. Okay. Moving on. Yeah. Something along those lines must have happened, really. Because you can't be that stupid. You can be that stupid, actually. And wow, down the fainted, you useless little child. Child? What do you call baby Pokemon? Baby Pokemon? Yeah. And how do you... Wait. Yeah, how do you tell Pokemon's age? By its level? Is that how... So at level 100, all your Pokemon die? Or is that how... It makes no sense. How can you judge a Pokemon's age? They never explained that in the anime or in any game. How do you explain a Pokemon's age? I am thinking right now. How? Because you get a Pokemon from an egg at level 1. So I'm guessing. Is it somehow linked to the levels? It must be. But then, since if a newly born Pokemon is level 1, then a Pokemon at level 100 must be ancient, like really old, about to die kind of thing. No, it actually should be dead. But then you can get like... It really makes no sense. Yeah, like, don't you think they should, implement... let's see. What should we call this? Like, you can breed Pokemon. I don't know what you call it, but this is the best example I can give you. You can come up with names yourselves. You can come up with name. No, why am I talking about? I just said that. Dumbass. Fixed palm. I'm not going to slap myself because it hurts. Okay. Where was I? Oh, yes. I was saying something about... Yeah, I know what I was saying. Okay. Why am I saying I'm saying too much. Damn, face palm again. No, I'm not going to face my palm. As I said before, I'm not going to face palm myself because it hurts. You can face palm yourselves for me if you want to. that will make me really happy. But then I don't take reliability if you get injured and you can't sue me. Okay. Wow, yeah, sorry brother. Yeah, I was just checking your video. Where was I again? I forgot. Oh yes, I remembered again. You can breed Pokemon in the Pokemon games and in the anime. But why don't Pokemon die? I think they should implement that into the game, make it more entertaining. Like, I said Ermigan. Damn it, I'm trying to say not saying that again. Like, you were so hard. You should really try to do a commentary yourselves, and then without a script, and then try doing it live, and then you cannot say the word it's so hard. Okay. 3, 2, 1. From now on, I'm not gonna say the word that doesn't count. Okay, for now. 3, 2, 1, go. Okay, not allowed to say the word. You know what the word is, because I just said it. Like 2 seconds or 3 seconds ago. No, 4 seconds, 5 seconds ago now. Okay, stop that acid. Anyway, as I was saying, no! I said it again! Okay, from now I'm not gonna say it. 3, 2, 1, now. Okay. As I was saying, before I was rudely interrupted by my speech. Yeah, my speech. Anyway, you can breed Pokemon, as I said before. Mima? Yeah, that's the word in Zambian or something. I didn't say the word that I said I wasn't going to say. I said Mziba. Yeah, that's a word from Zambia. It means banana. Banana. Banana, banana. Anyway. Ooh, does my Blitzel look like a banana? His head looks like a banana. It's like a deformed banana in the shape of a zigzag. Ooh, shiny badge. Anyway, as I was saying, another thing would be great if you can raise a Pokemon and see age. That'd be great. Like, if they implemented the age factor into the game. But then I'm guessing, like, once you've played about 2 years. Yeah, no, but then it. No, because then it'll look stupid on the other thing. Like, yeah, it will kind of look stupid. Okay, whatever. Stick with the Pokemon's age. Okay, the Pokemon ages as it levels up. Yeah, but then it evolves and changes, so it looks older. Huh. There's so much complications to this idea. And so much loopholes that I need to think. But whatever, it's just the basic idea. You like, whoa, what's the sound? You can come up with the backbone. No, I'll give you the backbone of it. And then you guys come up with the extras to get rid of the loopholes and stuff. Okay, like, you can breed Pokemon level 1. They're level 1. So, theoretically, at level 100, they should be dead. I think they should implement that into the game. So, like, your Pokemon gets older and older and older as you play with it. And it becomes more attached to you. And then eventually it will die. And then you have, like, a funeral for it. And then and then you get ghost Pokemon. When your Pokemon reaches level 100, I just said, do you want a banana? See what I did there. Anyway, yeah. Like, when your Pokemon dies at level 100, when you get to level 100 and it dies, it becomes ghost Pokemon, and then it gets something special. Or you can, the max level isn't 100, and when it becomes a ghost Pokemon, the max level is 150, which then, and it isn't, and it, no, wait, then be overpowered with like 100, level 100s versus like level 70s, it's not gonna really work now, is it? Yeah, it should be like level 50s, level 150, yeah, that should be the max, but you can't, like, there's no way of stopping action replay from doing it, is there? Yeah, the only way you can get a ghost Pokemon, you only get one ghost Pokemon in your team, and its max level can be like 136 or something, 135. And then, it's only obtainable through an event. Not an event, because then it'll be one in life kind of thing. It only can be obtainable, you have to talk to someone in the game, basically. Yeah, let's just say you have to talk to someone in the game. And then once your Pokemon's level 100, and then, I can't be bothered. I said again. I'm only carrying on saying I don't give a crap now. So I'm not unable to say that word. I'm guessing now. I'm guessing that if I say it a lot, I won't say it at all. later. So, okay, I'm good. Yeah, and then you talk to someone in the game, and then they kill your Pokemon, like the Staryu or something, but you can't see it because Pokemon's they've catered it towards like the 5-year-old and stuff now, because Pokemon Black and White is really easy. It really is. Like, you get so much help in the beginning, unlike Pokemon Leaf Green, Emerald, and that. Then those games are really hard. Well, I find them to be hard. Well, I find Leaf Green to be hard because of the Elite Four. I think they were the strongest Elite Four. And after that, like, all the Elite Four just became easy to beat. I never beat the Elite Four in Leaf Green easily. I never beat them in one go. I had to fight them. I would say 5 times, but I think it was more like 7. At least 7 times before beating them. And then, no, the problem was I could beat the Elite Four, but it was a champion. Like, I could beat Drake right then. And then, he would, like, lower my Charizard's health to, like, 50 or something. And all my Pokemon level 50 or something. No, all my Pokemon's HP to level. No, yeah, level 50. What the fuck am I talking about? Yes, I remember now. Yeah, he lowered my all my Pokemon's health to level 50. Not level 50, HP. Yeah, 50 HP. And then I had to use, like, all my Hyper Potions and stuff. And then whenever I fought Gary, he used to have, like, get past all his Pokemon except for the Gyarados. And when I did get past, like, Gyarados, I had to fight the, why is it called? Aerodactyl, that's it. I had to fight the Aerodactyl. And then that used to take my, and the only Pokemon I had, like, if I beat all the rest of the Pokemon, got past the Gyarados, the last Pokemon I always used to have, no matter what I did, was my Charizard. And it would just get taken out by the Aerodactyl because of its rock-type moves. Was it? Yeah, rock-type moves, because Charizard is flying and ground-type moves don't affect it. Yeah, it was rock-type moves. And it took the piss. And, like, when I beat the Elite Four once, I was really happy. And then I caught some new Pokemon. I tried training up my last couple of... Yeah, I tried training some Pokemon up because they didn't hang with the Elite Four because they died straight away, kind of thing. So I went to battle again. And then I got past, got to Gary again. And then I died. Again, I lost. So I said, okay, what can you do? It's close. Tried again. Drake killed me. Like, he killed one Pokemon. And I tried again. Got past Drake. And then I got to Gary again. And the cycle just kept repeating itself. So stupid. And I am really parched right now. And I shall take a sip of my Evian water. Excuse me, guys. That was nice. And on to another matter. You know when you I knocked out the Purloin. Wouldn't it, and just say that was a wild encounter now. I knocked out, you know when you catch a Pokemon, you have to get it to like red health, like 1 HP or 2 HP, something. And then throw your Pokeball. Wouldn't it make more sense to knock out the Pokemon? See, when Pokemon fainted, all its HP goes away. So you are theoretically saying that the Pokemon has died because it has no more health points left. Yeah, you are saying the Pokemon has died. So wouldn't it, but it has not died. So wouldn't it make more sense to throw the Pokeball when the Pokemon's fainted because it's not dead? And then it'd be much easier to cast it. Pardon me, better pick. Wouldn't it make more sense to throw a Pokeball when the Pokemon's fainted and it can't possibly put up any sort of resistance? So there's so many things they could implement to Pokemon. And so many things are stupid. And what the hell was that? I know, another point. They are so running, you can tell they're running out of ideas for Pokemon. Because you can look at that thing, it's like an embryo. It's a fetus, for God's sake. With the umbilical cord, yeah. Umbilical cord is still attached. What time is it now? It's coming to 13. No, I think it's past 13 minutes. It's around 14 minutes now, I think. Guys, I'm gonna have to end it here. As I said before, it's not my fault. If it was me, I would upload 20 minutes or 30 minutes. Yeah, my episodes will be 30 or 20 minutes each. Anyway, guys, I'm signing out here. Peace.